Mike Ruddock's men came into this game with the hope of closing the gap at the top of Division 1A, having defeated leaders Terranure in their sixth round encounter here last week. It was the home side who were firing in all cylinders from the off, and it didn't take long for them to land the first blow, as flanker Joe McSwiney blocked a kick from Staunton, and he ran the length of the pitch to touchdown. Deasy stepped up to add the extras with a routine conversion. Moments later, a multi-phase move saw Adam Boland set up lock Stephen Gardner, who would not be stopped on his way to the line, for what was a very classy second try.
Well done, Roachy.
Again, DC stepped up with no trouble in adding the extra two. Quick thinking by the Cookies 10, Staunton saw him set up a counter-attacking move with an intelligent kick forward. The ball was shipped from left to right, as Derry O'Connor was on the end of the pass to add the finishing touch for a positive response from the visitors. Lyons stepped up and he split the posts to leave a 7-point gap at the break.
Back him up, go with him.
The open nature of this encounter saw both sides having plenty of space to run into. This was clearly evident as Lansdowne's central pairing linked up to secure their third try, with Tom Farrell finishing off the move. DC's impressive kicking continued to make it three successful conversions. Ruddock's men, now looking to kill off the game, went to a maul from a well-executed line-out. The Munster men couldn't stop Joe McSwiney grounding the ball for what was his second try of the day. The posts were split once again and the points looked secure for the home side. Young Munster did look to launch a response, and this came in the shape of a penalty try, as they piled the pressure on the Lansdowne defence. The pressure continued with the Cookies pack driving towards the line once again, and there was no answer to the powerful maul as they made it over the whitewash to make the score a little bit more uncomfortable for the home side. Lyons added the extras, but it wasn't enough as time ticked on. The lead proved to be unassailable, with the game ending Lansdowne 28, Young Munster 21. And it's Lansdowne who remain hot on the heels of leaders Terranure.